In this video, I'm going to talk about the finite complement topology or the co-finite topology. Let's get started. We consider an arbitrary set X and define a collection of subsets of X as follows. Tau is the collection of all subset A of X such that the complement of A is finite or A is the empty set. It follows from the definition that A belongs to tau if and only if A is the empty set or the complement of A is finite. Therefore, A belongs to tau if and only if A is the empty set or there are x1, xm in X such that the complement of A is this finite set. And the latter means that A is X set minus this finite set. Next, I'm going to show that tau is a topology on X. First of all, the empty set belongs to tau by definition. Now, because the complement of X is the empty set, which is a finite set, we see that X belongs to tau. Next, we are going to show that tau is closed under the intersection of two sets. Take G1 in tau and G2 in tau. It is very important to consider the case where the set involved is finite, because remember that a set A belongs to tau if and only if A complement is finite or A is the empty set. If G1 is the empty set or G2 is the empty set, then their intersection is the empty set, which is an element of tau. So now we only need to consider the case where G1 is non-empty and G2 is non-empty. Then by the definition of the collection tau, the complement of G1 is finite and the complement of G2 is also finite. By the De Morgan law, the complement of the intersection of G1 and G2 is the union of their complements. Because this set is finite and this set is finite, their union is also finite. Therefore, G1 intersection T2 belongs to tau because its complement is finite. Finally, we are going to show that tau is closed under arbitrary union. Take a collection of subsets of tau, which means that G alpha is in tau for all alpha in I. If G alpha is the empty set for all alpha in I, then their union is also the empty set which belongs to tau. Now consider the case where there exists some index alpha naught such that G alpha naught is non-empty. We can use the De Morgan law again and have the following property. The complement of the union of this set is equal to the intersection of their complements. And this intersection is a subset of G alpha naught complement. And since G alpha naught complement is finite, and this set is a subset of this set is finite as well. By the definition of the collection tau, the union of G alpha, where alpha runs in I, belongs to tau. Therefore, tau is a topology on X, and X with tau is a topological space. Tau is called the finite complement topology or the co-finite topology on X. Now, we are going to explore some properties of open sets and closed sets in this topological space. Take two subsets A and F in X. First of all, remember that A is open if and only if A belongs to tau. From our first slide, we see that A is open if and only if A is the empty set or A is X set minus this, not a finite set. Okay, and remember that F is closed if and only if its complement is open. Therefore, by this property, we see that F is closed if and only if F is the entire space X or F is a finite set. The reason is the complement of the empty set is X, and the complement of this set is actually a finite set, namely the set X1, X2, Xm. In the next videos, we are going to discuss deeper topological properties such as the closure, density, T1 space, T2 space, continuity, compactness, connectedness. Now we are going to discuss these properties in the context of X with the finite complement topology. So we consider the topological space X tau, where tau is the finite complement topology. Note that if X itself is a finite set, then every subset of X, for every subset of X, its complement is finite as well. Therefore, it belongs to tau. So in this case, tau is the discrete topology or tau is the power set of x. So we only need to consider the case where x is an infinite set. The first property we have is, if A is an infinite set in X, then the closure of A is X. Thus, we can show that X is separable. Given two elements A and B in X that are distinct, and we define U this way and V this way. By the definition of tau, U and V are open sets. We also see that A belongs to U, B belongs to V, A doesn't belong to V, B doesn't belong to U, and then we see that tau, X with the tau is a T1 space. For two non-empty sets U and V, which are open, we can show that their intersection is non-empty by using contradiction. Therefore, we can see that X with tau is not a Hausdorff space. Another interesting property is any continuous function from X to R is a constant function, where R is equipped with the usual topology. We can also show that X is compact, but it is not connected. Please prove these properties by yourself. If you can't, please wait for our next videos where we will discuss all of these properties in detail. This completes our video on the finite complement topology. Thanks for watching.